So,
Together, y'all would have steam kinetics, though.
yeah, they could in theory. But, you know, controlling it's going to be a little bit wonky.
I will control it.
Not too wonky, but, you know.
There's if they can make the steam and I can control it.
Well, there's a higher thing to it. But
anyway, 13 was nothing to the intro.
So, well, I was going to say, okay, when we last left off, y'all had were just headed out after being doing your little, after getting back from your really bizarro trip to yesteryear, I guess, or to wherever the hell the drugs took you, perhaps.
None of that shit happened.
Wait, did I miss one session then?
Yeah, you did. Okay, I guess I'm going to have to get you caught up. Last time around, they ended up deciding to take the offer of the Information Society to get 5,000 of their people to fuck off the planet. And upon leaving, one ship went to the right and one went left, and the hunter-killer followed the ship that went left. One that went left had been segregated out ever so wonderfully and carefully by the Information Society so that the Mysterionicists were all being sent back to the Black Church. Oops. So you end up losing the Mysterionicist population as well as the Cyberpath population. Dope. Upon arriving at the system, there were three planets to choose from, one that was too hot, and one that was too cold, and one that was just right. So they went to the one that was just right, the one with the most robust biome. And then everybody found themselves very confused as a helmet was removed from their heads, and they all woke up and found themselves in a room in which this blackish drug was being pumped into their veins, and the equipment was being unhooked, and the varied valves and levers were being messed with, and the pump was slowing down, and you were all asked how well you enjoyed your experience.
Oh, man, it's fast far out. All right,
yes, you've been hooked up to
virtual world. Way back machine.
A simulation that was being forced through, that was a group hallucination caused by that funky black stuff.
And basically like the Arcanist.
And you exist 2 years. And you exist about 200 years in the future. Damn it, if you're going to cut everyone else off, that's one thing. If you're going to keep cutting me off, I'm going to kick your ass out.
Do it. Oh, 200 years in the future took that long, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep.
That long to get a stable settlement. The culture that you live in is fairly robust. It's fairly highly populated. The settlement was actually initially laid down on top of a plateau, upon which they planted the little seed of the Guardian Earth Spirit, which grew into one of those mighty trees like they have on there, the flower-shaped ones, and it grew so vast and so large that the upper parts of the city are now perched on the top of the great flowered-like plant.
Okay, hold on a second. I'm confused. What character am I using? Is this campaign
the new one? Campaign 2.
All right, I thought that we still had a few days left, but okay.
No, they decided to fast forward. They had decided to fast forward. So
okay, so what am I being woken up from? Like, how did that work? I thought
there was a helmet that was on you with a bunch of varied apparatus and wires and all this other funky stuff hooked up to it, as well as a bit of a pump. And in addition to this, there was a needle that was injected in your arm that the strange black goo was flowing through, the same kind that was the hallucinogenic, which had been discovered during your prior adventure by a different person in a different life that may or may not have actually existed.
Basically, everything we've played up to now, we believe, could have been a dream.
Although it feels awful real, and right as after the seed was planted, the elemental force, the Gaian, appeared before you, saying, "What the hell have you taken me here for?" In essence, there is already another Gaian spirit here that I will forever be in conflict with, and you must help me fight it that we may one day make this planet our own. I ask you all to enter into a pact with me now, and then upon returning to the current timeline, the real world, so to speak, Guyan spoke directly to your mind, saying, I ask you to renew your pact now, for the others have forgotten. Restore.
What is this elemental forest anyway?
The Guyan, the funky green thing that you've ran across, twice now? Three times?
The thing we saved.
Killed Mr. Smiley, and he came out.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, that's right. You've missed the two of them that he was in, weren't you? The Guyan spirit was the spirit of your planet, which in the final occasion when you came across it back on the other timeline, it basically turned itself into seed form so that you could take essentially the planet with you for all intents and purposes, or the spirit of the planet. And that has now been passed on to the current planet.
Okay,
it's a weird. Yeah, it's a little weird, but he expects his role-playing game.
Alright, so we started?
So, yeah, you've brought along basically the spirit of your former planet to the new habitat.
Does not compute. Okay, whatever. Imagine if
we took Mother Earth and we stuck her in a planet with Evil Bob, and now they are fighting each other inside the planet spiritually.
Still does not compute, but whatever. Okay. Wait, so do I have a past? Do I have any memories?
I don't know.
You have your memories from the planet that you are currently on, of all the work you've done up to this point, your employment, all this other stuff that coincides with the current character you're playing, as well as remembering your experience among the ancient Etu. Incidentally, the spelling of E2 has also evolved along with your people.
I noticed that. Oh, so it's kind of like I've been reincarnated.
Yeah, that's the closest way to put it, yes.
Alright. Considering most everyone else has gotten up, including, I guess, Boom's person.
Yep.
Okay.
Boom, are you still hanging around outside the building, or what's going on?
Oh, we're all up and about, and we're actually still talking with the people we just got.
Yeah, have that choice, seeing as I ran through to get that session over with, because I knew it had to be brief, because I was tired.
So that's where we left off.
Yeah, Thalu and Red have already left to go dance and sing on their street corner.
I went to go, me specifically, I'm going back to where I inhabit. So,
okay. So,
Me personally, I'm still in the lab, so I'd like to do a perception roll for any of that black substance I can possibly take with me. As I'm a doctor, I'd like to experiment with it.
The closest you could do is try and get a couple of the stray drops that landed on the bedclothes.
Yeah.
All right. I'd like to do that. So okay. You just add, I guess, a little vial of the black substance.
You're not even going to get a vial. The most you're going to get is a small piece of fabric cut off of the hole that's stained black.
You can try to squeeze some out of the needle that was in your arm.
Yeah, I was going
to
say, there's the needles that come out. Maybe I can slide some out and get a little taster.
Okay.
I don't want to actually taste it right now.
Is there anyone in the room who's like in charge of this? Like, can I ask why the fuck?
There are three people wearing lab coats in the room.
Okay, what's going on? Why was this? What, dude? He
volunteered for an experiment.
One of them sits there and smiles and says, yes, as was explained before, you will be a little bit disoriented. We do thank you for volunteering for participating in this drug trial. And we hope that the journey that you went on was a pleasing one.
When will we be getting paid?
Well, I'm gonna stand up and tap the patch on my back where I have been, where I'm concealing my pistol, to make sure it's still there.
It's still there.
Okay.
Oh wait, no, I'm sorry. It's in your little cubby hole. Everyone has one.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna walk over and gather my stuff and put it on and thank the researchers for the experience. And I want to ask, so what was that real? Where did this all come from?
Oh, don't be silly. This is just a way to connect people's telepathic abilities so that we can actually go and enjoy an adventure together. A virtual one, of course, where there's no real danger to us.
I see.
Wait a minute, then. So, just out of character, was the group hallucination the whole last campaign?
That's what they're alluding to.
Okay. That's interesting. That's very interesting.
Just wait.
How long have you been doing this?
Oh, we've only started up these trials about a week ago. We only had a few people during the first test group.
How much did we make today with our volunteering?
He smiles and says, "Volunteering, sir. I know you might be confused, but it was our understanding from the last group that the E2 didn't have any kind of currency, so I'm surprised you'd be confused by this."
Really? I thought we traded in Beckles.
Well, we do now, yes, yeah, certainly, but the ancient E2 didn't.
Look at him.
Gathering my bearings, kind of shaking my head, I'm going to look over at Kane and say, you're David, you had the rifle, right?
One of the researchers turns towards Kevin and says, "You see, I understand that you're obviously still a little bit disoriented, and you woke up a little bit later than some of the others, so perhaps you didn't hear this earlier. But we've been using this in part as a method, hoping to tap into some kind of community subconsciousness, we'll just say, or some kind of ancestral memory to try and figure out what the actual history of our people is, because there's so much myth and legend. I mean, there's even some that still try to believe there's some strange earth spirit that they brought with them here from their old planet. Which is, of course, ludicrous.
How preposterous.
What fools. Participate in another experiment?
Well, we are planning on having another one at some point next week. You're more than welcome to sign up. The sign-up sheets will not be going up. They'll be posted out front, probably in another day or two.
So we're on the lookout. Thank you.
Where does this stuff come from, anyway?
I'm afraid we're not at liberty to say at the time being. But don't worry, it's completely safe. It's entirely herbal.
Yeah.
So is the Tura.
So was heroin.
No, heroin's semi-synthetic. Anyway.
We've been informed that it grows from a strange plant, and we have those that have funded us to do further research into the substance. The people in charge of refining it do the refining, and we just simply do the testing. And what we do know is on a need-to-know basis, and frankly, we don't need to know.
I remember coming in here now. How long have we been doing this? How long have we been in that machine?
Oh, only about an hour.
An hour? Okay.
Yeah. Ooh, wow. Well, now that we have a monetary system, though, a little money would be
We have some money.
We have plenty of volunteers, sir. If you aren't willing to continue volunteering, that's entirely up to you.
Well, I'm very happy with the journey and the experience. I thought it was enlightening as to what things may have once been like. Me, myself, though, I have to go get ready for work, so I'm going to head out, guys.
You can either head out through the main exit, or you can head through the gallery if you'd like.
Oh, the gallery sounds lovely. I'll take a little stroll that way.
Well, by all means.
You as well.
And though I'm not in a hurry to leave, as it's only been an hour, would it be okay for me to come back at another time if I have more questions about what happened, whether you're doing an experiment on that day or not?
Well, we will be closed for the next 2 or 3 days. You'll get an idea when we'll be opening up again based upon the posting.
Okay.
Is there any bleeding effect with these drugs?
Bleeding effect?
Why bleeding? Well, as long as you keep that gauze and the bandage on your arm for a short period of time, your body should heal normally.
Well, I'm talking about specifically what we experience carrying forward.
Side effects.
Oh, certainly not. Why would there be any kind of side effects? That's just silly.
It's all natural.
It's just a psychoactive drug.
Yeah, that doesn't have side effects ever.
Well, also do keep in mind that we're also quite early into the trials.
That is worse.
So, seeing as I have a little bit of background with drugs and such, can I roll something to see if I've heard of this substance before, or?
Well, in the ancient past, you've heard of it, because but in terms of a present manifestation, no. You do know, however, in terms of the weird journey that you went on, and if that was at all accurate, then several of the plants that this material, this black goo, could be harvested from, were brought with you during the trip.
Remembering back, now after that bleeding comment, you were the one that tried to throw two bombs in one hole, weren't you?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
I have plausible deniability.
Oh, pretty paintings.
I think I need to go process this. I'll be exiting through the gallery.
Okay. These are not the bombs you're looking for.
Let me find.
I don't feel like I have any questions. I'm just gonna try and go back to my shop.
Okay. Well, thank you for participating, etc., etc., etc. Are you guys going to take the museum exit or the front door like Faelu did?
I guess we'll take the museum exit.
I'll stroll through the museum, for sure.
Why not?
Well, there's a number of odd items in there, many of which seem familiar. One of them, which is a strange ivory torque with a purple stone in it. A sword, which looks remarkably, at least like a replica of Synthola's CTT blade. There's a flak vest, which is tattered and worn, and has a few extra holes in it, possibly worn by somebody that was taken out at some point. There is what you recognize as being a druge head and a druge claw preserved in a jar of murky liquid. A fancy pin, which looks odd and is kind of this circular pattern with two round balls on it, which none of you remember actually seeing before, strangely enough. Let's see now. A lock of green hair in a crude sealed glass container. A replica of one of the explosive crystals, a darkling scythe claw replica. Let's see now. A couple of strange body parts preserved in clear liquid, one of which has a vague resemblance to that liver that you guys collected. Black metal arrowhead.
And that's my hammer.
An armor display from some strange scaly animal hide. And it looks like it used to have a hood attachment, which has been melted away from the inside out. Whoever was wearing this must have been shot directly in the face with a critical hit. A smallish gray box with strange writings. A strange reptile skull. An 18-inch rod with a glassy tip and metal probe sticking out of it. A gauntlet made from strange animal scales. And that's it for the first room.
What happened to our little baby monster?
You don't know.
Okay.
Oh, I'll continue walking through, looking at the cases, and proceed into the next room.
Okay. The next room has, some gloves reinforced with bluish metal spines on the knuckles. They look a lot like nut punchers, strangely enough.
In the nerds.
Fond memories of the nerds, I don't know. It's all so vague now.
Makes you all warm inside.
I remember feeling something soft and squishy between my knuckles.
A weird, ugly, bluish metal shield that's held together by rivets. An ornate pocket knife. A dark glass sphere set into a metal pedestal. Bone remnants of what was once some kind of bow, but the sinew that you would have recognized that was once holding it together is long gone at this point. A flashlight that actually is set up in a display so you can actually press a button and it still works. It's solar powered for what it's worth. A scaly whip that's in three pieces. The handle of a sword. A very dull metal katana. Three seeds that look like some kind of strange nut. A very old blunderbuss that most of the wood is eroded away on. A pistol which has no visible seams on it whatsoever. A strange rifle made out of an odd material that when you touch it feels like nothing you've felt before. A metal belt. and a display of strange objects that were, those of you that went to, were, over the course of the prior game, went to the meteor crash site, you'll recognize, blood-colored dust, a small sliver of black rock, very small, a star blossom plant, and some strange berries. And as you keep moving along, there's also a thin, metallic-looking, crown-like object, which looks like it once fit on a sil sheet.
I want to
by your eyes.
Run over to the display of the small black rock and look around and see if there's anyone that works at the museum nearby.
Well, for all the displays are indeed enclosed, and there are armed guards in the room with you.
I don't think we're going to be stealing anything. By the way,
I don't want to steal it.
Did any sil sheet come with us, or?
No.
Oh, we fucked that up.
Yeah, they got their own ride off the planet with the reptilians of the Fellowship. Or at least they were supposed to.
Hmm. Yeah.
So there's no one I can ask about the origins of that?
Oh, these are all replicas, one of the guards will say. Sorry, there is also a person standing in the room that's the official guide that can answer questions. These are all, of course, naturally replicas. Some of these, they of course claim are from initial items from hundreds of years ago, but as you can see, most of those things would be in fairly poor repair, and they just haven't figured out how to put them back together to make proper replicas.
Well, there's one thing that could have survived throughout time.
There's a couple things, actually.
Well, yeah, but there's one thing specifically.
Yeah,
but
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
I'm going to continue walking, then, out towards either the door or the next room, if there's one.
Okay. The next door leads to a small entryway by a very small library-like area, just a couple of shelves on either side, and then to another exit.
I look at the case that has Synthlo's blade in it just to see how secure it is.
Are you going to try and touch the case?
No.
Good. Well, from where you're looking, it looks secure. Incidentally, the blade itself is actually locked inside of a scabbard. I should have specified.
Okay. I want to take a good look at the books. Are there any ornate or gaudy-looking books?
Oh, yeah, they're all kind of... They're all leather-bound, all look very pretty, and all this other stuff.
None of them have any kind of trimming or gold leaf-type embossment?
Are you going to open one up on the exterior? No.
No, okay. I'll take whichever one is third from the left top shelf closest to the door.
Okay. You're going to take it and take a look inside of it?
Yes.
One of the guards is watching you suspiciously as you're thumbing through the book. It doesn't take long to thumb through the book. These are all there literally to be decorative. There's no writing inside of it.
I'll chuckle and put it back in place.
The guard clearly did not know this.
Alright, well, I'll walk out the door then.
Yeah, you all don't actually have a proper printing press right now, so it's actually quite pricey to make books, so it looks like these are just blanks to be made into proper books later.
I exit the door, take a look around the street.
Well, there are people going to and fro about their regular day. Now, in terms of the work around here, you guys all live in the lower segment of the city, which is a vast walled city around the base of the mighty mushroom-like stalk going up into the sky. Now, granted, the base of the city in this case is actually on top of a plateau as well. That's where the actual wall is. So you're quite secure where you are. Now, from what you remember from the ancient past, or think you remember from the ancient past, or may remember from the ancient past, whichever it may actually be, the forest had been fairly far away from where the plateau was. However, you know from your own personal experience that the forest is actually quite close to the outer edge of the plateau. Perhaps it's migrated, or perhaps the Gaian has done some more terraforming.
All right.
There are small carts and stalls lining the street, as well as many businesses along the row. Not too far from here, towards the central square of this particular part of town, you can see the two street performers doing their usual daily routine, trying to get whatever change they can.
I think I'm going to wander past them, drop half of Echo into their receptacle for whatever they're getting money for, and head towards the tavern that sparked my investigation.
The singer smiles, the dancer dances, and a mime not too far away looks on angrily.
You screwed over the mime.
What are you going to do, mime? You going to shout at me?
I would actually like
stick
to
stick my tongue out at him.
I would actually like to create a small sheet of ice under his feet so he falls.
Oh, you're a douchebag.
Well, who's really the douche here?
All of you.
Half of it.
Let's see here. One, two, three. There you go. I rolled a 12. That should make a puddle of ice under his feet.
Okay, you make a puddle of ice out of his feet. Let's see if his enhanced equilibrium helps him at all. And we get a quick 20. And I'm hoping that it won't, because I always vote against the mime. Oh, he manages to recover his balance and just wags a finger at you angrily. On a 3, he can definitely retain his balance. Unfortunately, the mime stands. Oh.
Yeah.
However, you have managed to get him trapped in a box, or maybe he did that on his own.
I thought you were doing that under Novik, not the mime.
Wait, Kevin, you have telekinetic powers. Actually, put him in a box. That'd be funny.
Nah. I don't get enough of this shit.
Hooligan. I'm gonna, hearing the mime lose his balance and then catch himself, I'm gonna walk back and give David a citation for using his powers in the burdening
You're
of others.
You're supposed to be undercover, by the way, out of game.
Well, he's undercover when he's in there. That doesn't necessarily need to maintain that way. There's a chance he might have met some of you in his daily war. Anyway.
Yep. Like I don't know if I've warned you about this before, but I've seen you going around being a hooligan. If I see you do this one more time, you're going in.
Yes, sir. I understand.
Technically, you could put him in a box with a very, very thin sheet of ice and then harden it, but it'd be as see-through as glass.
As you're continuing down the main road past the statue that they have in the center of town, that's allegedly of one of your founders. Which founder? No one knows. It seems to be the generic E2 statue, which looks nothing like the ancient E2 anyway. It's a tall, hairless person with furry feet for some weird reason.
It's Lenny!
I wasn't gonna say it.
I don't have furry feet. When did I ever have furry feet?
See, are you implying Lenny's a hobbit?
In a time once forgotten, Lenny was a hobbit.
Continuing on.
Okay, actually, yeah, just jump into D20 for a second.
I'm there.
I'm not actually putting you on the map or anything like that, but yeah, I'm just going to toss a map up for a little bit of flavor in a moment here. As you pass by this, you see one of the most popular local dives, which is referred to as the Rusty Sweater, so named for the chainmail. Old rusty chainmail that hangs in the window.
I'm gonna turn and walk in, because that's where I was going.
This particular dive, it's essentially a bar, it's a tavern, you can also order food there, is actually quite well known for its spiced alcoholic pear cider.
I'll walk up to the counter and say, do you have anything with apricot?
How much for one of the ciders? I want one.
Oh, it's going to be it's actually a full veckel.
Oh, okay.
I'll take 3.
How many veckels do I have?
Go to inventory.
Check your sheet, it'll be under inventory at the very bottom.
Yeah, I'll take one. I'm down to 16.
Okay. You're sat down on one of the tables as the barmaid goes rushing around, and I should probably add indie barmaid at some point, shouldn't I?
Oh man, I've got a lot of veckels.
Yeah, yeah, you're actually pretty good with the veckels. Let me figure out where I put my barmaid. Because I actually did get one.
Why does my Google Drive look so different than it used to?
Because Google, that's why.
Well, all I can see is my sheet.
Click on yep. Over on the left. If you don't see anything on the left, there's a little arrow that expands it out. Well,
I mean, I don't have. We're not sharing everyone's sheets this time.
I'm gonna get a drink, so I'm down to whatever money's in my inventory that nobody else knows I have.
It looked like you opened up copy of. You may want to open 13's, not your own.
Let's see.
It's under recent.
Do 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 do.
That's weird. Where the hell did I put her? Oh, well, you know I grabbed the damn barmaid. That sounds funny, doesn't it?
Yeah, you just keep grabbing all the ladies.
So did the bartender get a chuckle out of me asking for apricot?
He just looks at you odd and he says, what's an apricot?
How would he know what an apricot is?
I said, well, there was
some shit right there.
I was in here last week and someone was raving about it.
That's actually true. There was somebody in here that came in here last week, but they weren't raving about it. They were claiming that we used to sell it. Now, we do know that there are fruits out that we refer to by such a name, but it's never been something that we've distilled, and they're too far out for us to actually be able to collect them.
What would you be willing to pay for them?
Hey, far out, man.
That's all good, man. I was just trying to get a laugh out of you. You been having any funny business lately?
Well, in the back room, we have a rather large machine that takes care of the dicing and fermenting all on its own. It's using the latest technology to do so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Completely not what I meant, sir, but okay. Have you had anyone in here causing any more ruckus?
No, other than that one gentleman. But he was insisting that we had, and always it had been, selling this apricot rum.
Out of game, Lenny, I'm playing the part of a cop, so...
I understand, but I just...
it's like, what cop talks like that?
I bet...
Have there been any tomfoolery?
Or there's gonna be a fucking ruckus, son.
I bet Lenitar and I could arrange some ruckus.
Fucking anyway. Hell. None of that tomfoolery either, let me tell you.
Well, Well, thanks. I just wanted to check up on you. You got anything with some meat I can get on my way out?
Change my screen layout here right quick. I don't have my bottom bar. Screen region. There we go. Well, they actually do have quite a bit of food here. They don't actually have any fish at this time, but they do have plenty of other kinds of meat. They have been trying to restock on rice, but unfortunately they haven't been able to get rice in here for about a year now.
Well, barkeep, is there
any... Let me get a quarter pound of meat, and how much will that run me?
Oh, that's only going to cost you half of Eggle.
Oh, right.
He smiles and he says, "Our specialty does, of course, cost extra, but we assure you it's well worth it."
Yeah, I got one of those.
Yeah.
Shit's good.
Yes, it is. It's actually quite good.
Well, how long would that take to make? I kind of got to get out of here.
Oh, they tell you that it shouldn't take too long. They'll have to pass that back to the kitchen, though. At the very back of the bar is the doorway to the kitchen. Which is not showing up on this map, and I'm going to have to fix that.
All right, how much for that?
Wait, the one with the room with the barrels in it? I can see that.
Hang on. Yeah, I'm trying to... There we go. There we go, now it fits. Okay. There we go. Okay, no, at the very back of it, if you look, there's a brown door by that front entryway. And at the very back, there's a brown door, and in the left room, there's also another brown door. If you look right to the left, right here, hang on, right there, that is one of those, you know, it's basically a half wall.
Okay.
That has an area where they could put the food down, the beverages down prior to them being passed out to the main bar. You can see, looking from this angle here, from here toward there, that behind the large apparatus here, that there is a door back. Hold it down, come on, there we go. Yes, where they're pointing there. But the door to the main kitchen is back here.
Alright, how much for the specialty?
Oh, the specialty, of course, is a drink. The meals are all, and as you may notice, the actual bowls of the meals in them are fairly small. They don't serve large quantities.
Alright. Well, I'm on duty. I can't really go for a drink right now. Just let me get a quarter pound of whatever meat you suggest, and I'll take out here.
I wonder if there's a Mexican burrito roach coach somewhere outside.
No, there probably is, yes. And that'd be certainly cheaper than the half shekel that they're charging here.
Is there anything you'd be willing to pay if somebody could bring you back, say, a crate or two of those apricots and maybe some rice?
Are you that type of character? I don't know.
I am.
I actually am, too. Yeah. Out of game. Yeah.
Well, you only care about in-game now, Hushboom.
I know how to get stuff.
I look over at the guy interrupting my order.
Well, you could certainly try, but, I mean, the thing is, we'd need to have a large enough quantity of it to be able to actually serve it regularly for at least a good week or so for it to really be worth our while. I mean, it's great to have a personal stockpile, but enough that we could actually, for example, make a batch in the back or what have you. And even then, there's the Pear Cider is so popular that the chances of us replacing it with something else is incredibly unlikely. I mean, we are known for this. Back when we opened roughly 50 years ago, this is what we started with, and there's not much likelihood we're going to change it. We only have one set of equipment, and with how popular it is, yeah, the likelihood of us ever changing that. Which, incidentally, she says as she looks towards Nodvik, incidentally, that's part of why it confused us so much when somebody came in insisting that we had once made with apricot. We've never made with anything other than pear.
Yeah. So I've heard.
And when did you say this person came in again?
Oh, this was roughly a week ago.
Well, you know, if we happen to get it, you could hold it as just a delicacy. And only the finest people are able to gain access to it.
What kind of elitist are you?
Trying to be elitist is not how we became popular, she says as she starts heading to check on the other tables.
Well, barkeep, minding the chitter chatter here, is there any way I can get my order in?
Chitter chatter.
The barkeep kind of waves over to your table, nods, and hands the order in to one of the other waitresses.
He's like a nerd. I want to give a wedgie to.
Honest to God, let's see how many cliches we can bust out in an hour.
What kind of skullduggery is going on here?
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, I'm laughing at you in-game as well.
I know.
We're not laughing with you.
I'm sitting not at the table game. Laughing.
Okay, laughing so, why is it...
Shake my head.
What else... What other characters are around these parts? Who else is there? Anyone interesting?
Oh, you mean in the actual bar?
In the bar, yes. Other than these nutsos that are following me in here.
Actually, no. It is actually thronging with people, all in their varied forms of Victorian garden. Many of them young couples sitting there talking amongst themselves.
Is this actually repressed society?
We grow in population dramatically in 200 years, so we are not sexually repressed at all.
They have brothels.
Yeah, we are ambiguous.
Anyway, other than shaking my head and saying "damn hoodlums" under my breath,
I heard that
hoodlums, huh?
Like you would read.
Damn hooligans!
Damn hooligans!
Is there, in my observation, is there any darker area of the bar, quote unquote?
Well, look around the map. Does it look like it to you?
It means
where the black people are sitting.
I don't know. The corner down here looks like that would be where somebody who does bad things might sit.
Yeah, that's what he's looking
for.
I'm gonna go stick myself over there and. Any shady-looking characters? Anyone?
No.
Situate myself actually over here, if that's table. Which tables are free, basically?
Actually, almost all the tables are taken. One of the ones in the back of the party has just left.
I'm going to grab my pear cider and I'm going to flop up on these crates over here and just sit down for a moment.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna.
One of the servers walks by you after a few moments and asks you if you'd mind returning to your table, please.
Yeah, which table are we at?
We had a table?
Yeah, actually, the one over by the bar.
Oh, well, I will sit at that table.
Could I smoke in here?
Yes, you certainly could, but they prefer if you don't smolder too much.
I use my enhanced hearing to hear over here.
Wow. Just wow. He's real hot and horny for that chick. And she's liking it. Wow, okay. That was totally worth your effort.
That was, actually.
It's the most excitement Boone's had all week.
Well, maybe. That was definitely worth the effort. Alright, let's go.
Okay.
Well, as I chug down the last bit of my cider, I start walking towards the door and bid everybody a fair adieu.
A fair bar to you. Yes.
Okay, and walking out the front door, you're feeling a little bit...
I'll keep an eye out for those apricots.
As you're heading toward the door, you're feeling a little bit woozy from the drink. It actually hit you a little bit harder than you expected. It might partially be an after-effect of the drugs that you've been on for the last hour.
Hopefully I've got my meat now. I'm going to start eating it. And if he falls, I'll go over and pick him up.
He managed just fine.
I'm actually
going
to sit down by the door.
Oh, okay. One of the waiters comes over and asks you if everything's all right.
Good. Just catching my breath.
A little bit much for you, he says with a wink as he starts heading back over to check on other tables.
He just called you a pussy. You gonna take that, bro?
No, I'm gonna visit this bar fluently until I can drink a bunch of them.
Fluently.
There's okay.
Fluently.
A fluent bar patron. I don't know what that means, but okay.
Does no one know how to talk in this fucking world?
No, they don't.
Continuing to scarf down on me, as I walk towards the door to leave, I'm going to look down at him.
World, dude.
I'm going to look down at him sitting down and say, don't cause any trouble.
Actually, could you
yes, Dad.
Help me to my apartment? I don't know if I can make it.
That I can do, and I'll lift him up.
Thank you.
I'm good.
Okay, so the good doctor is helped back to his place by Nodvik's character. Anything else the rest of y'all want to check on before heading out?
I can't think of anything.
Good, because neither can I.
Yeah. I was just going to say, I'm going to listen throughout the whole bar and see if I can pick up.
Before I get up, just look underneath the table for hidden messages.
Okay, you find nothing.
You find lots of chewed up stuff stuck to the bottom of the table.
However, if you want to stare at the carefully placed stonework underneath your feet long enough, you might actually see some kind of strange pattern emerge, but, that's just pattern fail on your part.
Pareidolia?
Yeah, that is the word I was looking for. Thank you. Pareidolia.
Isn't that the space between your balls and your asshole?
It's close enough.
That's but, the germ or something like that.
The taint. Because it taint your butt
crack. The grundle, the fleshy fun bridge.
Yep.
Okay.
Taint your skin flute, taint your poop shoot. That's why we call it taint.
Do I pick up any rumors?
Well, okay. Oh, are you going to listen to rumors in there? Are you going to scope out other tables, or?
Well, yeah, just use my enhance ring to while we were doing this whole
thing. Okay, there are a number of rumors around town, one of which about somebody that's working on some kind of strange new kind of glass lens. There are rumors, of course, about, frankly, the experiment you were just part of. there's rumors also that there have been a strange number of people that have just all of a sudden been having strange kind of mental problems and having all kinds of delusions, and that they've had to take several of these people and put them inside the local insanitarium.
Insanitarium?
Yes, the sanitarium. And I'm throwing in there for fun, because they're in. In any case, there's also rumors of a new organized crime family. There are, let's see now...
I'm the only one who gets this, by the way, so you can't act on it.
There's also rumors that somebody has been trying to get away from society and is trying to start some strange river lodge or some sort with some kind of houseboat.
I will use my aerokinesis to sort of deny a good portion of the oxygen, persuading David to pass out before returning to the office. I don't want him leaving, wandering around drunk and causing trouble.
God, that is a horrible. You're pretty mean.
You're horrible people.
Yes, I am. I told you, I'm just a little bit. Out of game, I told you that I don't know what my character's personality is until he's playing, so that's what it is, it looks like.
You're also
going to roll for that. I may be able to save.
There is also a rumor that there is a secret armory in the back room of this restaurant. Or rather, this tavern.
All good rumors.
Yep.
Damn, I should have did what I was thinking about doing earlier. Too late now, though.
And there's even one strange person in the very back that's running around insisting that there are vampires.
Vampire!
Some things never change.
I bet he's part of the mercantile.
So assisting him... Go ahead.
Is that a guy or a girl?
It's a girl.
Is her name Bella?
It might be.
Does someone sparkle?
No, nobody's sparkling.
Anyway... After assisting David into his bed and helping him pass out with subtle aerokinesis, I'm going to head back to the police station, the office.
Okay. After heading back to the office, your senior, one of your seniors comes in and asks you if you've found out any useful information pertaining to the experiments that they were doing.
It's crazy down there, Sergeant Vaylor.
Well, this has been going on for a couple months now, he informs you.
They're definitely hiding things from the volunteers, as they call them.
Well, that's usually the way it goes with these kind of outfits. First they try to get the volunteers, and the next thing you know, they have them hooked, and it's a street drug.
Yeah, that definitely warrants more investigation. I don't know how volatile... I don't know how volatile what they're using may be. If you want me to go in again, I will. However, being the nature of what they've been doing and what we've seen in the past on the streets, to keep myself from becoming hooked on it, I don't know if you want me there or not.
Well, we really still don't know all that much about that. This is all hypothetical. We haven't sent anyone there before. There's a conflict here. Before you were sent there, they told you that the last agent they sent disappeared.
I'm going to look at them suspiciously and say, well, it's a very well-outfitted operation. It is something we need to look further into.
Well, we look forward to hearing back your future reports.
At which time, I want to read surface thoughts on them. Oh, wait, sorry, I can't. All I have is mind probe right now.
You try to read surface thoughts and go, fuck. Wait, wrong life.
I don't have that anymore. Well... I'll head back and start filing my official report on paper.
Papyrus. It's paper.
I guess I'm going to leave the bar and return to my office, I guess. Do I have an office?
Office that you work out of. It's in the lower... It's in the back room of a... in your case, it's going to be of a little fix-it shop. Where they sell and trade very different things. It's kind of an antique kind of stuff.
Hey, 13, do I have to be still to use the ability where I don't get noticed? And I'm talking about that one.
You can move slowly.
Oh, okay.
But being still certainly does help. You're more likely to be noticed if you move.
The second level.
Other than out of the way.
Yeah.
After writing my report, I'll go on patrol.
Okay.
Okay.
In my car.
Okay. Vroom vroom. Mm-hmm. Actually, more like putter putter putter.
Yep.
A little bit of smoke coming out at the top. Poof, poof, poof. Unlike Boom and his farting horse.
What?
Yes, I called that right. Boom has the farting horse. The mechanical horse that when it stops, it goes poof. AKA farting horse.
Waking up. I feel
suffocated.
Somewhat woozy, as if the oxygen had been completely deprived from my brain.
Yeah, you haven't woken up yet.
It wasn't completely deprived. It was a very subtle reduction to get you to pass out sooner. And then I stopped it as soon as you passed out.
Anyways, I'm where I am, and I want to use my ability, and I'm going to roll for that one. So that way, okay, hold on.
It's kind of weird with all of us separate.
We'll meet up.
And I'm going to...
What are you trying to do?
Declare before you roll.
Yeah. I'm going to try to, and then he rolls.
Yeah, you need to declare before you roll.
No, I was declaring an action, but...
Okay, did you declare the action before the 19 or before the 1?
In between.
Before
he declared
one.
That he was going to do something, but he never declared what.
He said doesn't ability.
Your Skype.
Yeah. Oh, it's in Skype. Fine.
Oh.
I'm keeping my abilities from everyone else. That's what I'm doing.
You don't need to do that.
I'm fine with doing that.
Yes, you have an actual location for your work, and fine, you have your cloak. And what are you going to do?
Resist remain in this, yeah, with the cloak on.
You're just going to stand around being obscure.
Well, traveling out.
I'm hidden.
Okay, so you're heading back secretly then. Try not to be noticed on your way back. Oh, well, that just saves some. Okay.
Yeah, okay. And basically eavesdrop on everyone as I fell.
That's fine, because as I patrol... Okay, I failed anyway. I was going to say, as I patrol, I have radar on anyway.
Alright, is there anyone back at my work to talk to? Anything that needs to be done? Maybe a little more to go off here.
Right now, your days go through pretty much the standard rigmarole. Dodvik does his patrol. Thalu dances. The doctor eventually wakes up and gets his ass to work and works his second shift. He has strange, troubling dreams, but doesn't actually remember them. Eventually, night comes. The lamplighters come out and start lighting the varied lamps around town. And give me one second to find what the fuck I'm looking for here. Where is it?
And by the way, Navik, you went...
There we go.
What's the security like at the hospital?
Oh, the security's very light.
Okay. On my way out tonight, I would like to pocket some anesthetics and bandages and things of that sort. Maybe even a surgical kit if I can get it to slip in without being noticed.
Well, you should be able to try and smuggle that out. As I said, the security's fairly light here. It's still a relatively trusting society. After all, you do have the Thought Police.
Yeah, out of game, David. Just do what you did when you stole the TV from school. Just act like you know what you're doing.
Okay, keeping in mind that this is being recorded. Okay.
TV? This was many, many years ago, no worries.
They got it back.
Now, keeping in mind that your characters don't really, per se, know each other. You don't really know who each other are, what they do, and what have you. And so far, the only real frame of reference is that you once went to this one particular pub together. After the lamplighters come out, and it's time for everyone to call it a night, and you can hear the noises of the wild filtering in over the wall. Horrid animals and beasts that have been kept out by the walls for years, that in general the E2 don't give much thought to. Why should you have to? You do quite well within this city as well as within its sister city, and you take dirigibles from one to the next. There's not much need to go wandering through the woods or any of this kind of thing at this point. At this particular stage. So, in general, your people don't. You travel by airship and you seem to be fine with that. The cities expand slowly by building new wall segments, and eventually the interior of the city will grow out to meet these new wall segments. As sleep overtakes you, you all find yourselves on a ship riding back towards town, or rather towards this planet. Being loaded onto the ships, rather, prior to heading back to this planet. It's as if you're back under the influence of the drug. Perhaps it's just the lingering effects of it. But you're standing in those lines, being slowly segregated from ship to ship. dream commences now.
Wait, so this is us going back from, or leaving, what, New Eden?
This is the bleeding effect I was talking about.
Yeah. Yeah, this is a lingering effect of the drugs. You all are sharing a drug-induced dream, and you are back at the point at which you are being sorted by the teleporter onto what you now know was two ships, not the one that they claimed you were being sent to.
Okay. Do I have my Stage 2 abilities or Stage 1?
You have Stage 1 abilities. Like, stage 1 abilities.
Do I have anything on shield?
And well, Owen's character is not there. Sweet. Owen is elsewhere.
Gotcha. So I'm me?
Yeah. You're the first okay. You.
So I look around and I look for the others that I usually party with. Are and, they nearby?
Yeah, some of them are there. Thalu standing in line. Actually, Thalu is exiting from line, deciding that she's going to say to hell with it and go on the hunter killer. Kevin is character is there in line, as is Nodvik, as is Booms. New one.
I approach each of them and pull them aside and I say, are you you? Do you know what's going on?
We were in our city, but we were here. What?
You remember having a drink with me earlier today, correct?
Yeah, they do.
All right.
While we're here, I know it's different. I know Galad is real here. I believe Galad is watching us, but there it was not. I don't know which is real.
Well, let's play as if both is real. And I hate to say this, but the drug could have a very, very strong effect on us, mentally speaking. If we get damaged one, you could be damaged in the other. So just presume
your mind makes it real.
Yeah, just go with it being
real. Are there any aliens around?
The aliens that are around are the Black Church aliens that are supervising you guys being sent up through the teleporter to the ship that is in orbit. Technically, the ships. Now, granted, your people believe they're all being sent to the same location.
So these two ships, they founded, what, the two separate cities there, or...?
No, one of these ships went found the city there. The other ship was sent back to the Black Church headquarters because they wanted the Mysterionicus for themselves.
Shitheads.
They're separating us. I at least remember this. I think this already happened. We were here before.
I remember traveling to the planet before. We separate, though. We're not together. This is a trick. It's a lie. We have to somehow save our people.
I put my hand on David's shoulder and go, if the other is true, then this doesn't matter.
What if it does?
Even if we try, it's not like actually traveling through time. You're just...
What if we could? Time.
Oh, no, I have about time. For truth.
We're here. The right thing to do, because we know what happens, is to try to save our people. It doesn't matter if this is even a dream. Even in our dream, we should try to save our people.
Becomes more complicated than that. Could end up with
the we can always tell the Black Church guards to go get fucked.
If it's not real, it doesn't matter, right?
That is true, and there was the effect that in which I, as well as other people, moved into other bodies. Well, I moved into
bodies, bodies,
and that's all I know.
So, while these two are discussing this, I want to sort. How many people are like sorting the people through the teleports? How many of them are operating it to change where who's going?
There's about 20 people.
There's 20 people there, but how many are actually operating it that say who's going where?
Two?
Okay.
So we all have our level 1 abilities, and that's it?
Every time someone that I know to be Mysterionix walks up to the teleporter...
Do you want to be there on a different host?
You'd be
I don't know
different...
what you mean.
Do you want to be your monkey self, or do you want to be in a different host? You can be in a different host if you'd like. Different body than the Mungunny.
Which means you'd have different abilities.
I will leave that player's choice. Basically, it's a matter of whether you want to be in your Mungunny self back at the Fellowship camp, trying to figure out what the fuck to do about what's just happened because your boss got shot in the last theoretical adventure.
Oh, okay, sure, I get it. That's fine.
Yeah.
So anyway, as I was saying, while these two are discussing, I'm going to watch every time someone goes up there that I know to be Mysterionics empowered. I want to project thoughts on the one that seems to be doing the most button pressing to say that one's a psionicist. He goes here.
Okay.
By the way, we can all talk to each other through my mass telepathy link.
Yep.
Without them hearing us.
Yeah.
And I'm going to try and confuse the other guard.
Okay. You're going to just plain try to confuse him?
Well,
it's going to be an aggressive action.
If you confuse him, he might just start pressing the buttons randomly. That's my concern.
Well, no, hold on. There's two of them. Nodvik said he was going to do that to the one, and I was going to confuse the other one so he doesn't notice anything.
Oh, I gotcha. So he doesn't notice what the other one's doing. Okay.
Okay.
The one that's not pushing buttons. Gotcha.
Yeah.
I will do the roll for you, if you don't mind.
Okay.
Feel free.
And we're good. Okay. Things go fairly smoothly. You manage to get all your people on board, or at least the majority of them on board one of your ships, and then you guys are all brought forward toward the teleporter to be teleported onto your own. Once aboard that ship, you blast off and you start heading back towards the planet that you were designated to go to. There comes a point that one ship turns left and the other one turns right. The hunter-killer follows the ship that goes left. You continue traveling right. You eventually arrive at the system that you've come to, and you come to the determination once again of deciding which ship to choose from. Now, the people on board the ship are siding towards going to the more comfortable planet and landing by where the plateaued region is, because it does seem to provide the best amount of protection.
Nodvik. If we run into conflict with them again, if they come after us, we'll need to be prepared. We need to find...
We're at the point of picking the planet again.
Yeah, I know. This is what I'm saying to you. I remember everything we do on that planet. While it is a somewhat normalized life, and I know we do well there up to that point, we need to be prepared. And this one over here, pointing at the warmer one, seems to have more available to us for us to prepare in that manner.
Since we're on the ship still, we could actually find that out. The ship should be able to do a mineral analysis.
This is after the scanner, and he already told us that.
Yeah.
Well, it should tell. You should also
it,
have. Some
it does seem to have more minerals on it. The most robust biome, and thus the most food, will be available on the planet in the middle. The ice planet's pretty sparse, and kind of nasty.
Yeah. So, and the other thing is we could actually do a scan to see where the hell the actual minerals are on the planet. So that way we can plan around that.
It'll take some mining to get to some of the better minerals. However, there is, it's pretty well diversified. However, there isn't nearly the robust kinds of biomes that you have on the other. Most of it's jungle or swamp-like, with a lot of arid places in between.
Is there any somewhat less agriculturally grown in valley, mostly surrounded by mountains?
Not so much with the valleys. The valleys would be more desert climates. You don't have any good grasslands on that planet.
Well, which one are we talking about?
The one that's closer.
The
hotter planet.
Yeah.
I turn to Nodvik and
it also doesn't look that suitable for most of your crops.
I turn to the object and I say, the comfortable planet seems the most likely for our survival. What is your argument towards the warmer planet or the colder planet, though?
Yeah. Well, my the thing is...
I was addressing Nodvik.
My argument for the warmer planet is strictly in case they decide to come after the rest of us, because, hell, why the fuck not? That's what I get from that Raven guy. So I feel we need to prepare for more combat.
Well, the other thing, too, is we do have that spirit, so it can... turn the land habitable if we happen to go towards
it. It is
the
habitable.
No, the hot one. We're talking about the hot one.
I am referring to the hot one. It's still habitable. It's just swampy.
Well, no. If we choose the desert area,
we know that the Gaian spirit can terraform it to grow plants.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I was talking about.
13. Did you not say that the comfortable planet had more animal life?
Yes, the comfortable one had the most animal and plant life.
So if we're looking for a planet that would allow us to do the most training and the most growth as far as combat, that would be our suitable planet as well.
Yeah, I agree.
Training, I agree, but what about armaments?
He also said it had the highest mineral.
No, the highest mineral was the closest.
Oh.
Highest mineral wealth.
I'm good with anywhere.
It also has probably more unique or rare minerals than the closest one.
An onlooker that's been listening in, kind of from the aside, looks over and he says, yeah, but they don't have apricots on the one that's closer.
Okay, dude, that settles it.
It's you. I arrested you.
No, you didn't.
I don't think that apricots really matter since they are tasteless.
Damn it! I want back my apricots. They matter.
You could get apricots later on.
Wait, hold on. Wait a minute. Remember being part of an experiment and like, is this a dream?
Because. Technically speaking,
every time we have one of the sessions, this happens. The night that follows, every night we get a chance to change one thing that we did during the session before. One night, and last time it cost me my apricots.
What did you change?
Not much, he says. All we changed was whether we had Silshi with us or not. And we didn't bring that many, and they ended up dying off after we arrived. Which is kind of a shame, but...
So, when you took the Silshi with, that got rid of the apricots?
Yeah, no, because because we landed in a different location because of the Silshi.
Have you ever been to the mountainous planet?
The close one or the far one?
The warm one, the close one. Have you ever landed
there? No, but the far one's cold, he says after a pause.
I suggest that in this reality, we attempt to land on the close one to see what it's like.
We could try that.
I mean, really, what's really going to change, you know?
Well,
everything.
If you switch the planet, everything changes. Yeah, you don't want to know what it was like on that cold planet. We ended up with a really small population living in a mountain.
Exactly.
I vote for not changing the planets.
I vote for changing planet.
I want my apricots, he says angrily as he motions towards his knife belt.
Okay, we heard your vote. Do we have weapons on us, by the way?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I have my pocket knife, too.
This guy's just posturing, clearly.
Yeah.
I say, that's not a knife, and I pull out my CTT pocket knife. This is a knife.
No, I say, that's not a knife, and I pull out my sword.
What sword? This character doesn't have that. Or are you pulling out a regular one?
I pull out my vibro blade.
Now that's a blade.
The joke is over.
Yeah. I whip my dick out.
Yeah, the joke was over. Anyway.
The guy says, I don't think that we have any dead people today, do we?
We don't, actually.
What are you going to piss on?
We didn't lose anyone important.
Ooh.
Well, we have the Mistrianesis with us this time.
Yes.
Yep.
That is what we changed.
Yep.
I think we should leave it at that.
I would like to see what happens to our people now that we have more people. I think we should just stay the route we were on, I guess. Yeah, if we get another chance, we should try the warm planet.
There you go.
You can have your blast apricots.
Just because I know how far we've gotten to. And who knows? Let's spread rumors when we land about how good apricots are. Maybe we can get yours back.
He chuckles. As you arrive on the planet, everyone is slowly ferried down once again from the ships until the very last of you there, and the seed is planted in the ground as was before. But this time, when the Gaian appears before you, he looks and he just shakes his head and he says, again. Again, we are at this point. And again, I am here. So be it. The pact shall be renewed. At which point, you guys all wake up going, that was fucked up, man.
Well, is it early morning? Is it midnight?
Oh, it's early morning. The sun has just risen over the city. It stands tall and proud. Your people have spent quite a bit of time trying to go out into the wild, trying to tame the areas around this, trying to terraform what you can of it for the Gaian. Now, granted, the Gaian hasn't been seen in a great number of years, but the legend of the Gaian still stands, although there are many that don't believe in the Gaian anymore. The evidence that as you spread out further that the land does seem to change at a faster rate still seems to have some wondering why, while others insisting that it still is the influence of the Gaian.
Is it a work day or a day of rest?
This is actually a weekend.
Go ahead.
Given what we just changed, I'm going to roll obscure knowledge on the subject of Miscreon.
There may or may not be Miscreon, but there are people that claim to have abilities different than yours. They've never been able to provide evidence for them, but they've claimed them plenty enough, and they've been persecuted to the point that they do not live in the main city with the rest of you. They live out in the wilds.
I thought we brought a lot of Miscreon with us.
We did, but that was on the ship that turned left.
That was on the Hunter Killer.
Ah, shit. Well, that's interesting. I'd like to go seek them out.
I would like to, since it's a day of rest, take a walk and with a concealed pistol, of course, and head over to any kind of park or any kind of rest area that's close to the trunk of the tree.
Okay. The only place where you guys have all met, there are only two of them, one of them being the Rusty Sweater, and the other one being the place where you actually initially used the drug.
My character is going to get a drink on his day off.
Sounds like a good plan.
My character is going to listen for rumors of things that people need to get rid of.
That's awful specific.
Are you guys doing all this in the morning?
Yes.
Hell yeah, I'm getting a drink in the morning.
Vela will be sleeping in.
Yep.
If there's no one there, then I'm going to get rid of that.
Hey, you guys remember that faithless guy from our hallucination? I wonder what happened to him.
The faithless shall not prevail.
Remember that Sasha guy? He was even weirder.
Anyway, I'm just at the park or whatever, putting my hand on the
You can't talk to them, you're not at the same place. Okay, you put your hand on the trunk of the tree.
Do I feel anything?
Yes, you feel the minor rumble of the guy in sleeping.
Boom, who did you invite?
I don't know, Nain's or Sed. Nain's or Sed.
Man. This is not a shuffle.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they...
They need to catch back up, and they need to make characters, which is why they hadn't been invited, because they do not have characters in the new setting yet.
With that feeling, I'm going to...
unable to get through to them on that.
With that feeling, I'm going to briskly head to the Rusty Sweater.
Okay. Well, eventually, Thalu shows up, followed by anyone else?
I guess I'll join
I have
them.
Some stuff I'd like to try and do in the morning.
Okay.
If it's possible.
Okay, what do you want to take care of, Owen? Minotaur.
I'd like to try and make some Kevlar armor in my shop, or something relatively equivalent for the time period.
Okay. You spend your morning trying to make something to go under your armor to protect yourself. It takes a little bit of time and a little bit of effort, but you do manage to get it done. This will take you till about noon to complete.
Sounds great.
Kevlar?
Okay. Fibrous armor, yes.
Okay.
He said similar too.
Wait a minute, hold on. Is that museum open?
The museum is open.
I want to go there. I have something specific that I want to do there.
Okay. Head to the museum, Kevin.
Any of the objects changed from last time?
Let me take a quick look. Let me open up that document. Museum junk. There we go. There it is. Okay, let's see now. The strange animal skull is no longer there. Nor is the black metallic arrow. The little piece of the black stone is larger than it had been in the past, or in the yesterday. The flashlight is broken, and there's only two out of the three unusual seeds, and the darkling scythe is in much better condition.
Object reading on the black stone.
Okay, it's Mysterium.
Obviously.
It's actual Mysterium.
Does it tell me any more than that?
No. No, you're just able to recognize what it is. It had been brought with it. It had been brought here by one of the original settlers in their pocket at that.
For reference 13, I've lowered my money by another two. Okay. Since it's around noon, I've had two drinks.
Well, hang on. We'll get to you and your drinks in a moment.
How many times can I use that?
Right now, that's all you can actually get off of it. This thing has it, other than the person that put it here, which was the proprietor of the museum, who's also one of the researchers, you can't find out too much about this particular rock.
No, I mean object reading. How many
without
times can I use that?
Physically touching it, at least.
And it's in a case.
Yeah.
He's just asking if he can keep using it on other objects.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you can.
The seeds.
The seeds you're not able to get a read of from touching the glass.
Is there anything that's not in the case?
The only thing that... Well, actually, the flashlight, yes.
All right. Yeah, why not? Flashlight.
The flashlight is a replica of the flashlight that was made by a local worker just a few years ago, which explains why it doesn't look quite right.
And that's different from the last one, right?
Last time it was the actual legitimate item.
The reason is because the Mysterionics would allow people to emanate light, and we wouldn't need the flashlight.
Okay.
That's interesting. Alright. I'm gonna head to the bar and rejoin them.
Okay. Owen, you finish up your armor and your basic body armor, which will give you an added 1 PR at this point. And part of that's because you're already starting with 3, so augmenting 3 is a little bit harder.
Sure, reasonable.
Okay, as you guys all arrive at the tavern, and let me load up the tavern here once again. You are greeted by the waitress, who's bouncing around, pleasant little blonde with her serving tray. And she invites you all in there, and you sit down, actually at the same table, a different table, a little bit further from the bar this time. Let me let you all know where you are on the map here. There we go, right there. And of course she asks you if you'd like a glass of their world-famous spiced apple cider.
Oh, it's apple cider now.
How recent are the apples?
What do you mean, how recent are the apples?
How fresh is what I meant.
Oh, well, we have an orchard toward the back of the city where we grow our own apples. We've been doing it this way for about 20 years now.
Well, I would like a small glass of apple cider.
Oh, would you like to have a bite to eat with that? We have plenty of different kinds of fish here. Unfortunately, it's a little bit harder to get meat from the countryside that's still fresh, but we do keep a good stockpile of fish and rice.
Yeah, absolutely. I would definitely take some fish.
That's wonderful. Happened? We do actually make an excellent fish curry.
Yeah, what makes meat so scarce around this time of year?
Oh, well, when we actually ended up expanding our borders, we did it toward the nearest water supply, because, of course, this is the most logical thing to do. So we actually have quite a number of lakes and streams within our territory, and we even have the wall built around one segment of it. So we have some fresh rivers flowing directly through the city.
Do you have any other drinks available?
Oh, well, that is the primary, of course, but we do also, and she kind of lowers her voice and says it loud enough to make sure the other tables hear her whispering loudly. She says, but of course, we do have a wine cellar in the back.
Do they have...
You go basically through our back room in the basement. There, we have a substantial wine cellar down there now.
What type of flavors are there?
She gives you the listing. There's reds, there's whites, etc. It's all grape.
Oh, grape. That would be apricot.
Yeah, that's made off-site. That's made off-site. They actually get that from one of the local distilleries.
I'll tell you what, I haven't had any breakfast yet. Can I get
vineyards, whatever.
Can I get some kind of pastry, some kind of bread food, and anything with apricots?
No, unfortunately, we haven't found apricots the entire time we've been on the planet. We do have records of them, and
stuff we should already know.
Yeah. I heard from a somewhat
You're disoriented still.
Yeah. I heard from a somewhat unreliable source that you guys had something with apricots. That's all right.
Yeah, that rumor's been going around lately. I don't know why. I mean, every once in a blue moon, you'll see a couple filter into the city from the Badlands, but that's about it. Certainly not enough to actually brew anything. And if someone were to try it, it would cost a small fortune, I'm sure. Granted, I'm sure the owner would be more than happy to sell such a thing if he could come across it, so if you know anyone.
Streetwise, do I know where those could be?
She just said Badlands.
I'm asking if I know. No, I'm asking if I know any more from my ability.
Yep, hang on.
Yep, and I use that too. You know, I'll watch.
Yeah, you do, Kevin. You know somebody who brews all kinds of unusual beverages, for that matter.
And that's me. And I got enough.
Actually, no. I just rolled an 8 for Kevin.
No, I rolled 1 for me.
But this guy's also involved with the local organized crime division.
I might have to go talk to him.
No, you certainly.
Wait, organized crime division. Is he with the police?
No,
opposite.
Okay.
You know what organized crime is.
So you said division at the end. It's like,
I was in here last night. Actually, could I just get the same thing I had last night?
Yeah, sure, no problem. He says as he puts your order in, put your order in. A little while later, they bring out fish sticks and french fries. Not what you got the night before.
Yeah, I pick up one of the fish sticks and I look over at Kane, even though I only know him as David. I look over at him and say, David, this isn't what I got, is it?
No.
I don't think. Does David remember?
He was there.
I was there.
That was before he got drunk.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, this is the point at which Thelu actually walks into the bar. She sees you over there and says, oh, I remember y'all from that. Whatever. And then she goes over and sits down at a nearby table, immediately calls over the waitress, asks her for some of the spiced apple cider, and for asks what their catch of the day is for the fish.
Do I have to let the D? No, I don't.
So,
ask Thelu, how did you know it changed to apples so easily?
What are you talking about? It's been apples for 20 years.
Wait, wasn't apples last time? Or pears?
We didn't talk to Thelu.
But she should have had the memory.
Oh, well. But Thelu turned left with red.
That's right. I want to say, do you remember what happened when you went on the other thing?
Yeah, we got blown to shit.
Say that so casually. Have you done it more than that, though, two times?
Man, well, twice now.
You woke up in your bed this morning after that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's interesting.
But yeah, we ended up, we were chased down by a couple fighters and a few other small ships, and we were blown to crap. We gave it another shot last night, but yeah. It was interesting.
We probably should have saved Red Thalu.
No, we're going to beat the fuckers. You got to figure out how. It'd be nice if we had another ship.
Unfortunately,
if we were all in the Hunter Killer,
that we'd all die.
Well, you would have to talk the Black Church into reinforcing it.
I don't suppose I know a guy who has a ship.
No, not
200 years ago.
Well, we tried to actually hide. The thing is that we found out that after doing it the first time that there's some kind of docking station that we're supposed to dock the Hunter Killer with. And last night we tried to get it, and Black Church didn't like it too much, and they ended up blowing us out of the sky. But we'll figure it out.
Your Hunter Killer, does it have ammo?
Yeah. Well, it would if we docked. That's the thing, is you need to dock it with this thing up in orbit to be able to have weapon systems. The first time we couldn't even fight back. This time we tried to get that weird thing that it connects to so that we could fight back, but we failed and got blown out.
Oh, interesting.
Well, you might want to make sure you check up on any recognition system.
What happens when you get to the planet anyway?
We have three planets we can choose from when we get here. One of them is freezing. Apparently that's been tried by another group and almost everyone dies off. One planet that's a lot warmer that we haven't tried yet, and then this one that forces our friend to be in eternal conflict.
Well, yes, and last night anyway, we were able to get the Mysterionicists to come with us and confuse the Black Church guards, so...
But weren't they always here?
No.
She says if she moves over to your table and picks up a chair and pulls up a chair.
From your perspective, they would be. For us, last night, the society was a bit different.
Yeah, how does that work?
This place stirs.
How if I know? I'd love to know that.
The apple cider used to be pear cider. Before that, it was apricots. And
okay, I know you're just screwing with me. It's been apple the whole time.
By the way, 13, did you change the map?
Yes.
The colors, the colors of the bar changed.
Yes, it's changed.
Have you noticed? So you finally noticed that the food's different, the beverages all look different. Yes, it's a different map.
I wasn't quite sure what.
It was pears before. It was apricots before that. And see this? I asked them for the same thing that I ate last night. They brought me fish sticks today. Last night I had some kind of meat, some kind of land animal.
Yeah.
By the way, Kevin, I don't know if you noticed or not, but it's no longer stools in the back tables. It's now proper chairs.
Ah, I see that. What the fuck is going on here?
Pay attention, trippy. Man.
I haven't been paying attention. Shut up.
Actually, he seems to be the first one that really noticed the level of detail differences.
I noticed it a while ago. I noticed the apples right up away. I just assumed they were apricots.
So, Taylor, you're telling me that, as far as you know, the Mysterionics have always lived on this planet?
Well, they don't really have Mysterionics anymore. They keep pretending to.
Well,
needs the rock to work, so...
Yeah, I guess you guys wouldn't know this. On the way here, I took a little side trip at the museum, and, there's an actual Mysterium rock in there. So at least we know where at least one of them is. Yeah, the little gray black stone. I used one of my talents on it, and, yeah, it's real. It's not a replica. Well,
yeah,
so at least we know where one of them is.
Well, there should have been people carrying
charge
with him.
Thalu, for my entire life, there's not been Mysterionics or even the rumor of them living. Until last night, I hadn't seen them in years. Or even, for that matter, for many lives, I've not seen them. I don't know what's going on anymore.
Many lives? That sounds so weird, she says.
Well, I can't understand it myself, but... It seems like I'm living multiple lives at once.
Well, maybe you're just getting confused because you're going to the planet. Try dying next time. She says with a wink.
Actually, I believe he did die once.
Yeah, I will...
Sorry about that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, Kev, I don't know Kevin's actual...
It's just, I literally, out of game, I literally just changed the I to a Y.
Okay. Alright. Kevin, you say it's real Mysterium. That's interesting. I will need to look into that. I assume at this point they know I'm a cop.
Phelan. Let me just change Should that we... there. Oh, but you can stop calling me that. My name's Okami.
Okami, I'm sorry. Should we meet again in one of our dreams, follow us. Don't get on the hunter-killer.
She wants to kill the thing.
But
she wants to win.
I want to kill those little fuckers.
Maybe we should all get on the hunter-killer.
It's too bad you follow you. It's too bad your ship can't dance.
She shrugs and says, neither can I.
Oh, that's different.
I'm a singer and a musician. She says, tapping the guitar that's over her shoulder.
Yeah, that is what she does.
My partner really? Dances.
Really? Can you sing us a song?
Sure. She says, and looks around and says, but the owners always get fickle when I start trying to panhandle in here, so I better not.
13's just trying to get out of singing.
Oh, no, I would simply say she sings. Fuck that.
All right. Well, I'd say, how about this? Before you started doing the experiments, as you know, everyone here can sort of do different things, but very minor things. I seem to be able to handle myself better. Have you noticed the same thing?
What do you mean by handling yourself better?
She doesn't know.
I raise a hand and start blowing her hair back with the aerokinesis. I feel more precise.
She shrugs. She says, I'm just a singer.
How about you guys? I'm looking at the rest of the party.
I turn to Nodvik and I look at his glass and I turn it to solid ice.
I use levitate and circle myself around the table a few times and sit my ass back down. That was fun.
That's going to scare the shit out of everyone in the bar.
No, they just figure he's using a mental power.
Yeah.
Okay. Everyone has
There's an S for levitation, so that's not too big a deal.
Oh, okay.
He just seems like he's really good at it.
Yeah. So it seems easier for you guys as well.
Things have been changing.
Oh, I guess I haven't noticed as much. Well, you know, other than when we killed Synthola by mistake.
What?
Wait, what?
Well, the first time around we killed him. And then the second time that I went down there, we ended up saving him. And then this third time, he ended up leaving the planet. Oh, I've been going for 3 weeks, she says.
Ah.
They told us we were the second group.
Well, that changed, too. They don't remember the groups that came before. Either that or they're lying. I don't know which.
Oh, my God. We should document this somehow together, in this life and in the previous life.
Oh, actually, if you write down notes about it, it's really neat. They're gone when you come back. The first time I thought that somebody had broken into our place, but there was no signs of anything else being messed with.
We need to find a way into that lab.
Well,
notes.
Well, if they work through telekinesis, go ahead then. Yeah. So I think how this works, and this is just a hunch, with its innate ability to use to connect with your psychic level, and some other thing that I haven't quite factored in yet. It allows for us to not only travel through time, but actually connect with those minds in the past.
Wait, so after the experiments were over, did they ask us, like, to give an account of what happened?
Oh, they recorded. Thelu says, they didn't tell you that? They were actually tried to record it on the machine.
Yeah, they didn't say anything about that.
I don't know how they're recording it. They haven't told me anything about that. My only guess is that they took some of it from the ship. Oh, have you ever seen the ship?
No.
No.
Oh, it's on the top level. The old lander, the Goliath class transport ship, still up there. It's in like pieces now. It's just this empty shell, but it's still there.
Could you take me?
Yeah, we'd have to take the elevator up.
That's okay. I'll make some stairs.
It's an awful long way up. Yeah.
We'll take the fucking elevator.
Yeah.
But isn't the lab going to be locked so we couldn't use the elevator?
We're not going to the lab.
No, it's not in the lab. It's over by the tree. How did you guys really get that screwed up at that last trip?
Not me. I remember the elevator. I've been up it twice. I've just never been to the ship.
Yeah, it's a steam elevator that we have going up. It's attached to the steam plant. Steam.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm good for that then.
Yeah, it's a tube. It's an elevator, and it just shoots you up to the next level. It's a little rough. You have to strap in, but you know.
That black shit's fucking with my head with these drinks.
It can't be worse than when we were strapped into the ship with the tiger.
Ah, you remember that too, huh? Remember that Gary guy? What a nut.
That guy, if I find who, if someone was going back and see...
Actually, this last one was the best one. The last one's the only one he showed up in.
Really? So
yeah.
Must be the person that was in the experiment then.
That'd be really cool.
I think I want to find who was controlling him and slap him.
Well, he's not here, so I wonder why.
Well, he did kill that one idiot that kept running around claiming he was a paladin.
Oh, she's talking about the lore.
I thought so too.
Anyway. That's what I was joking.
I thought it was Gary as well. Yeah. But anyway. So yeah, Tiger only shows up when Synthola leaves.
No, this was he only showed up in the third one.
And that's the only one that Synthola left in.
Yeah, well, in the first one, all these bugs showed up, the same ones that shot us down in this last one. The last one before I had the second dream. But the bugs that shot us down in the Hunter Killer the first time around, well, the first time this last time, she stops and says, "This is getting really confusing, I know. This during the trip, we got shot down by these bugs and little fighters and stuff. But then when we went back in last night's dream, we got shot down by the Black Church. But those bugs, the very first time I went through the simulation, all those bugs and stuff, they came to try and rescue us towards the end."
Hmm. During the first time before we were involved, your very first time, were there any other ways off the planet?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. The first time around, Synthola helped. Or at least he tried to help, but he ended up getting killed at the end. It was kind of messy. He tried, though. But after the bug showed up, then the big Black Church fleet came, and then it kind of went the same from there, but the bugs came a little bit late because it took him a while to get his communicator repaired. The second time around, well, that just didn't work out too well. But the third time, well, you know what happened.
Well, that's interesting. Wait, what happened the second time?
They killed Synthola.
Yeah, he infiltrated the E2, and when some idiot brought the Flannix back and he turned into, you know, the fox kind of looking thing with the tails, the E2 freaked out and thought he was a monster too and killed him.
Makes sense.
It's very E2-ish.
Yeah.
When Synthola helped, did they bring the Flannix back?
No. No, they figured out it was a trap the first time. It seems like they did everything better the first time.
Sounds that way. Anyway, take a little ride in the elevator by now.
Boom wasn't around to offend him.
Actually, that was more than Boom.
Yeah, anyway.
Yeah, I know.
Well, you head over to where the theoretical elevator is. And instead of it being a long tube being controlled by steam, like Thalu is indicating, upon arriving there, there are three espers that are actually controlling the machinery using a modified form of levitation to actually bring the platform up to the top with some assistance from the steam works. The platform slowly makes its way all the way up to the very top tier of the city. up here, it's a lot nicer than the slums that you're living in. And you're given some dirty looks from some people, including the local authorities, who question the wisdom of letting you in. And she informs them that you just want to go see the museum of the original ship that landed here. And they end up agreeing and send you with an escort, to which Thalu comments, well, the escort's new. They bring you in towards the very center section of the city, where the Goliath-class transport is still resting to this day. It looks a little bit charred and a little bit burnt out, like it's been through hell. But it still looks like it's intact on the outside. You're not let on board or inside to look at it like she indicated, and it's not nearly as bad as she had claimed.
Thalu, does the ship appear different than you remember previously?
It was kind of in pieces last time.
Hmm.
The last time I was up here was 3 trips ago, and we kind of crashed it on our last trip.
What did you crash it into?
She shrugs and she says, I wasn't on that ship, I don't know.
Okay, I can't.
What time of day is it now?
Oh, it is about, say, 2 o'clock.
I think we might should go back to the bar and come back here when it's a little bit later and see if we can't maybe sneak aboard the ship and look and see what they're hiding.
The security looks pretty serious on topside and always has been. The elite live up here.
I think we should go downstairs and go to that museum. I want to talk to the curator.
Well, we should look at the museum here first and then do that because while we're able to have access here.
Yeah.
Oh. How long are we going to go with this? Because I'm getting a bit
of headache. What I'll do is I'm going to use clairvoyance to look inside the ship.
Not much longer. Okay. Using clairvoyance, you look inside the ship. Most of the consoles have been torn apart. Well, it looks pretty well intact on the outside. Internally, everything that had once been part of the inner workings of the ship has been completely scrapped.
We take it to heart so that way we can use it. Yeah.
I'll describe the inside of the party before wanting to go to the other museum.
Okay. You head back down once again with armed escort. Head over to the platform and are lowered down. Once again, there are 2 espers assisting in the raising and lowering of the platform. It allows for it to move quicker than it would normally, in theory. Or at least that's what they insist. Upon arriving back down in the lower levels where the regular people live,
scrubs.
Mm-hmm. You're able to head back down and check out the museum if you'd like.
Did I happen to get the name of the organized family?
The Mafia family? You can get that while you're at work.
Yeah.
It might have changed since yesterday, so, you know.
Hey, yeah, what do you do again, Boo?
I can dance. I'm an entertainer.
Bullshit.
You don't know that.
Anyway. Upon arriving at the museum and going in, I do want to find staff and request talking to the curator, flashing my badge like an idiot.
On the way to the museum, Thalu pauses at one point and says, I'm sorry. No rest for the weary. And she goes over and heads towards her apartment because whether it's a weekend or not, she still has to work. And for her, this is one of the better days for performing. Okay, as you arrive at the museum, the curator is sitting at a desk in the corner going over some old notes.
Excuse me, sir. I'm conducting an investigation on an underground society, a sort of a cult that worships the past, that intends on taking some of your exhibits. Would you mind if I investigate a few of them?
Then who the hell are you, he says.
I flash my badge.
Oh, well, sure thing, officer.
Okay.
Thank you.
I'm following.
So I just basically I just want the cases open so I can look around for any kind of tampering.
As you're walking away, you hear him mutter, well, at least he didn't want to probe me. I always get tired when they want to probe me.
By the way, I do want to activate my mental shield.
Okay.
Nodvik, do you have object reading?
No.
Okay, I do.
That's okay. I don't trust you as a cop at this point. I trust you as someone back in the old time, though.
One of the varied guides for the gallery walks up to hassle you, who is then called over by the curator, who speaks to them softly for a moment, at which point the guide returns over and says, "Anything you need, sir, please just let me know."
Thank you. I just want to, if you can, just open up the cases as we get to them. I just want to peer in there, make sure I don't see any tampering.
What kind of tampering are you looking for, sir? Some of these cases are sealed and cannot be opened.
I'm primarily worried about the more valuable appearing things, metals, shiny things, that kind of thing. I just want to look and see if there's any kind of devices or anything someone may have planted. I've heard rumors of people wanting to steal your stuff.
Well, okay, sir. If you insist, she says, looking nervously over at the curator. Okay, let me open up my junk.
Guilty. Hang the bitch.
So, officer, I was wondering why the sudden interest in our facility.
There's, like I told the curator, there's just rumors of a society that worships the past, or at least their interpretation of what happened when we got here, and they want to bring back some strange religion or something like that, and they think these things might help them.
She chuckles and says, "Well, I mean, there's no way for us to possibly really know what happened in the past. It'd be interesting if we could try and conduct some kind of experiment or something to find out, but, you know, that's certainly beyond our capabilities at this point."
And I agree, I'm just worried.
Isn't the museum attached to the lab doing the experiment?
Yes, it was.
Yes. Oh, it was?
Yeah, yesterday.
So where is it?
We don't know right now.
Awesome.
So upon examining them, which cases get opened?
Let's see now. The container that holds the torque, the sword, and the fancy logo is opened. However, the torque is in its own very carefully sealed box that's made out of a strange crystalline material. Okay.
So everything there seems good, and that's out of both rooms?
The vest seems to be perfectly fine. The jars of murky liquid with the animal parts in them. The druge parts that are in these are no longer from the same druge. They're not from two or three different druges. The logo pin is no longer there, sorry. Let's see now. The claw side is in exceptional condition. And as you move into the next room, the animal hide is... I believe that was still there. The arrowhead is missing, and then we have the smallish gray box with unusual writing.
Interesting. It's a bullet box.
Do you mind if I do any appraisals on anything? Or...
You wouldn't have any way to appraise these. These are not things that are sold in your timeline.
Well, do you mind checking Skype for just a second, 13?
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Okay, so I do want to walk up to the mystery room and say, how well is this secured?
Yeah, one moment.
That's okay, baby.
Oh, okay.
Sound good?
Yeah.
All right.
No problem. Okay. She says, they say that this is one of the original fragments that were brought with us, she says, as she takes out the stone, handling it carefully. She says, it's actually not as brittle as some people say. It's actually fairly sturdy, she says, as she very carefully kind of taps it against the counter and says, here, and hands it off to you.
Alright, take a look at it. Hold on to it.
It's a rock.
Can I touch that for object reading?
Yeah. Sure. I'm not handing it over, though. I'm just letting you touch it.
Okay.
What are you looking to learn about the object?
Would it tell me anything more than it did last time?
Well, the question is whether you're looking for some kind of specific information.
Origin. Where it came from?
No. Like, oh, that's where it came from, 13's had kind of explained that out of character.
But, yeah, it's from the creation of the universe, and you can't go that back that far.
Yeah.
Well, I meant how it got here, but whatever.
Well, how it got here was in the pocket of, strangely enough, Apricot Guy.
Really?
Apricot Guy brought it. He smuggled it on board. And you actually, after doing your object read on it, you're rather disgusted by where he sorted to smuggle it.
Okay, that's about all I wanted to know.
I'll look at the person helping us and say, this matches the description of what I think they're actually after. Keep an eye on this, and I hand it back to her.
She looks at it and goes, this? How bizarre. It's just a useless stone. At which point she takes it and puts it back in the display and seals up the display.
All right, well, I'm done.
Okay, at this point she walks you into the third room, where there's quite a number of additional devices, old armaments from the early days of the E2. There's, for example, one of the old bolt throwers that you had. And when I say bolt, I'm talking crossbow. These are basically automatic crossbows. There's a couple suits of the old chainmail and armor and what have you. All made out of standard iron, of course.
Yeah, iron charm.
And in the very back of the room, there's an old stone with a number of names chiseled on it. These were the names of the original colonists who had left this behind, and it's a recreation, apparently, of the original stone. While glancing at it, you do notice that some of the names are spelled wrong. The replica's not quite exact, but it'll have to do.
Do I see my name?
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
Did they spell it right?
No, they didn't.
Fuckers.
No.
Do I see Tobin's name there?
Tobin's name is not on it. Damn, he was not one of the original settlers.
But he wasn't, valued. That's okay.
No, he died long before, way before ever getting here.
Yeah. I was hoping he'd be memorialized somewhere.
Who's Tobin?
Tobin was the spiritual leader of the Pathkeepers.
Who he died in like the second session.
Yeah. Well, he's my character's namesake. So.
The guy's looking at you all like you've completely lost your mind.
Yeah. All right. Again, just keep an eye on that in particular, and everything seems okay so far. But I may come in again in the future to check again.
13 perception, real quick. While we're inside the building, are there windows? Anything that's sort of the walls?
Yeah, there are windows. They're a little bit high up on the wall, but there are indeed windows.
Around what size?
Let's see now. They're about 8 inches high and about a foot and a half long.
Perfect.
Okay. Are they openable? Could you potentially open them?
It doesn't look like it. At least you don't see a mechanism for it.
It's a museum. Museums generally just have the glass to let the sun in. They don't open.
Yes.
But anyway, I'm done doing my little investigation and finding out what I wanted to find out. In my own mind.
Is the building air conditioned?
No, it's not. Or at least if it is, it's not on.
Well, guys, before we all head to bed or get to work, whatever each of us has to do for the day, I think we should all go have a drink and just relax for a few moments.
For a doctor, you're really into your alcohol.
Well, okay. It's the only way I can deal with the stress of the horrific things I see every day. Amazing, brutal.
Which he means his wife.
Would you like to check back in with the head of our museum before you head back out? She says. Okay, sure. As she's leading you back towards the old man, she brings you down a slightly different route so you can cut between the first and the second. As you're going by, there is a smallish room on the right that the door has been left open to. Make a perception roll, please.
Enhance eyes or whatever sense I'm using.
Four.
Nubba got that one.
Okay, three of you glance in there and notice the partially covered machinery and equipment that's in there. as well as a small plant that you recognize as being of the sort that has the black goo in it. The machinery in there is the partially assembled machinery from the experiment.
So the experiments haven't started yet?
Not in this timeline.
It's taking longer.
Oh, and incidentally, the plant is a very, very small one. It looks like a sap. It looks like just a little bit of a bud with just a touch of the black crap in it.
All right. And is there anything else in there? Any other doors, cubby holes, that kind of stuff?
Not since you're able to see at a glance.
Clairvoyance.
Not me.
Four on clairvoyance.
No. There. Well, sorry. There is another door, but it looks like it leads to a closet.
Okay. Got another little Skype message for you, 13.
Okay.
Yep. Also, I turn to the person guiding us, and I say, hey, that's a cool-looking plant. What do you know about it?
I'm sorry, sir, but I have no information on that.
Oh. It looks almost otherworldly. I haven't seen anything like that on our planet before. It's pretty cool.
On our planet?
Well, the proprietor does have a interest in botany.
Hmm. I myself, being a doctor, do enjoy experimenting with herbs from time to time.
Well, they are talking about having some experiment going on in here at some point in the future, but we have no idea when the equipment will even be ready, she says with a shrug.
Hmm.
But this is just what I overhear from my coworkers.
Well, I like to think of myself as a man of science. I would be interested in partaking if y'all ever get that set up.
She leads you over. She starts leading you out of the hallway toward the proprietor's desk.
Yeah, make sure you get that sanctioned.
Oh, of course, sir.
I lean over to her and I whisper, if you need any assistance to getting special stuff, you know.
She looks at you with a great deal of confusion, seeing as she's just works here.
Yeah, you should probably talk to the,
the curator.
Let's get into the curator.
Okay, so y'all head over toward get over to the curator. Whoop, there you are. Okay.
All right. Well, sir, everything seems to be in order at this time. I've told your colleague here, but I'll tell you, the black rock, the useless rock, as she described it, matches the description of what the rumors are that I've heard. You may want to keep an extra eye on that, but everything else seems in order to me.
Well, thank you, officer. I will make sure to do what I can to tighten up my own security here, I guess, he says with a little bit of a shrug. We've never had any kind of problems with theft. Everything here is pretty well useless.
Yeah, right now they're just mostly unsubstantiated rumors, but I just felt the need to look into them because they have been circling around.
Okay, well, if you feel like I need more security, let me know. I'd be more than happy to head down to the station and pay additional dues.
No, I don't mean to sound like I'm hustling you, sir.
He looks at you funny and he goes, no, I mean for their increased police security. This, you know, you pay your dues.
Yeah, I'll just make sure I'll put this on part of my patrol route just to check out on you, and now and then you don't need to worry about that.
Thank you, sir, he says with a little bit of a note of confusion in his voice.
Alright, and other than that, I'm done here. I guess I'll walk out.
Okay.
And they're Teamscape.
Yeah, I saw.
Okay, good.
And I'm going to head to the bar, guys, and get a drink. If anybody'd like to join me, maybe we can sit around and discuss our museum visit.
It's my day off. I'd like a bit of that pear apple cider.
Yeah. I like some of that apricot shit.
I think I'm going
hang
to
on a second.
Relax
boom,
and
boom.
Get a bottle of wine.
What are you doing the same as Dave?
No. Same thing as in the same thing I did before. Same ability. It's already
you should probably explain more.
Oh, he's listening and eavesdropping for rumors inside the museum.
No. Okay. That's not. I'll just recopy them. All right.
There you go. That's
I
a good
idea.
I just
wonder what the hell you're talking about, because what Dave's doing is, yeah, I know that you're doing that, but he's doing something quite different.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. He's in.
Yeah, he's. What he's doing is what he's doing, and yeah.
Alright, so we'll go into the bar, we'll get a drink.
I have to get with Lenny on the side.
Okay, yeah. Y'all head out, y'all do your little drink thing.
Holding on to my drink, not quite drunk, and I'm gonna wait for Damp to get a bit inebriated and then mind probe him.
Well, I'm only sipping on some wine this time, actually, but,
Oh, the wine's actually quite good.
Oh, okay.
Incidentally, there are no real rumors toward, like, resistance or rebellion or people upset about the class thing. Everyone's pretty happy with the current leadership in the city.
Wait, did the whole class thing exist last time?
Yeah, but it wasn't considered favorable last time.
Interesting.
Well, guys, that rock is definitely part of the Mysterium, the rock that was on the old planet, and we saved the Mysterionics guys. They may actually want that. I was mostly blowing air up my ass to get a better investigation there, but... We should definitely see if we can't make contact with them and see and let them know that we believe them. We know where the powers come from. I don't know how willing you guys are to work with me, but I want to find out more about what happened and what's going on.
Well, yeah, same here. I'm awful confused right now.
And I hang back to the museum, doing what I was using my ability for, which 13 even saw, in the same room as the curator.
Okay.
I would be willing to work with you, Nodvik. I believe we have a lot to gain by aiding each other in connecting our past and our future.
I would agree. Given your apartment is just a block away from mine, I don't think that should be too hard to organize.
Well, seeing as we've kind of all been stuck in this together, and I don't know, it doesn't seem that anyone else around here has been having similar dreams other than, like, Thalu. And I have some useful connections that we might be useful to us in the future.
I'd like to find Mr. Apricot and apologize that we only have apples right now.
I do have a question for you.
And I know I have a guy for that, so perhaps we can obtain some of that apricot.
Oh my god, with the apricots.
Yeah, I know. I sort of
going to be a running
gag, apparently.
Yes, it will be a running gag.
I got a guy for apricots.
It's running on its own now.
Yep.
I just want apricots.
And I do want to know what those things taste like. That guy seemed to really love them.
Hey, cop buddy, your name tag is a little blurry at the moment. What does your name actually say?
My name is Tobin, and I know you as David. What is your name here?
I'm Kane.
Nice to meet you, Kane.
Well, I'm Kelvin, with a Y.
Tobin, I have a question for you, given our recent meetings and our agreement to work with each other on these projects. Not so much to call you a good cop or a bad cop, but we may need to do some things outside of the boundary of laws. How would you feel about this?
I may be a cop. I'm only recently a cop. Before that, I had my own private practice. It didn't turn out to be so luxurious as I thought it was when I first got into it, but after a few years there, I ended up joining the police force. I'm known to bend the rules back then, but so far I've been legitimate.
Well, my proposal would involve breaking, severely shattering some rules.
That I may not be okay with.
Then perhaps for some of these projects we should go our own ways.
I probably would be.
Just don't let me be the one to catch you, because just because we've been through these together doesn't mean I won't throw your butt in the slammer.
It's okay. I'll make sure not to incriminate you in any way.
Well, I'd like to clairvoyance the wine cellar.
It's a wine cellar.
Nothing down there other than that?
Yep, just a bunch of big casks. If you were actually... Hang on, let me let you clairvoyance it. Give me a moment here, and let me add it back up there. Let's see now.
And Lenny, did you get my Skype message?
Checking. Hang on, so I sometimes don't get Skype messages until like way after I receive them.
If you actually add the person, it'll come.
Mine works that way too. Now mine, sometimes I don't get it for days. It's weird.
I've never had that.
Circles. Mine will circle.
There you go.
A long time before it's in
circle.
Yeah, I'm not seeing it.
So the room. Yeah, it's just me. I'm clairvoyancing. So the armory that was rumored to be back there doesn't appear to be there anymore.
Nope.
Okay. And then no people are down there either. All right.
Nope.
You're already tied up down there. That's good.
Something for you to try, Lenny. Go to the 12th Tribes Skype thing.
Yep.
Click there. On 14 participants and click on my name.
14 participants.
Okay. I'll just expand the group at the top.
And you He's are a peacekeeper.
Yep.
And you could add him. Actually, I'm going to add him as well.
Okay. Send it again.
All right.
And I can re-archive the wine cellars, no longer needed. I got a map for every fucking thing.
So, how is the state of the Galad religion? Does it still exist?
No.
Well, the gas giant's not there anymore.
Exactly.
And especially if you leave one planet, go to another one, I'm pretty sure they kind of forget it pretty quickly.
No, the religion is Gaian. Actually, after your people got here, it shifted from Galad to Gaian. It was interpreted that it was the Galad thing was a misinterpretation of the name Gaian.
Hmm.
Yep.
Or at least that's what modern lore says.
Well, theological retcon.
Yeah, we know how that works.
Well, let's put it this way. You have a giant thing that was just sitting there. Then you have a giant thing that's actually interacting with you.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure we know what people are going to go with.
Okay. So, I do want to go to the Insanitarium and see if it's acceptable policy to pay Apricot Guy a visit.
Is that where he is?
Yes.
How do you know?
I wasn't asking you.
Because that's where he was taken a week ago, according to yesterday's account.
That was a different world.
As of right now, that's where my character assumes he is. Still.
What? We don't know that he's still there.
I know, but as right now, that was the last place my character knew him to be.
I didn't even realize that that's where he is taken, but okay.
Yeah, I wasn't stated during this session. Not Vic, due to the fact that he's playing a cop, got a separate briefing.
Yeah.
All right, Lenny, I briefed you.
All right, I got it.
All right.
Sound good?
Well, they're doing that. I'm going to do my thing in the museum.
Okay, what do you want to do, Boom? Seeing as you're trying not to be noticed until you get noticed.
Yeah, I was trying not to be noticed while they all left.
You're waiting for people that work in the museum to leave, or just the party?
No, just the party.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not going to steal anything. I don't have that.
Where's Nodvik and Kevin at the moment?
Go ahead.
I went home. My head hurts.
Okay.
Okay. And let's wrap this up quick, because I'm going to be calling it a night soon, in theory.
Yeah, it's going to be real quick. So, I use fast talking as a persuasion method, to try to persuade the curator that I happen to know where this project leads, and that it does lead into very positive territories that we do want to go into, and that I would definitely be interested in helping him to gather the materials or anything he particularly needs as quickly as possible. For a profit, of course.
What in the world are you talking about?
Let me roll for fast talking.
Fast talking is a
bit different. You need to play it, dude.
Yeah, you just have to roleplay, dude.
Yeah. Well, no, that's skill, but I actually have, I'm going to say
things. You have to talk it through.
Yeah. Alright. Well, with that special plant that you have, it and the machinery that you're designing, it not only will allow us to see into the past, it'll allow us to affect the past. And, of course, you don't believe me on this, but there are things...
Oh, no, I certainly do believe you, sir.
Hmm. Interesting.
Yeah, everything you've said is quite compelling, he says in a very wide-eyed, nervous manner.
Yes, so I think it'd be beneficial, considering I was at the end of the project, in order to help guide it towards that specific point.
That's wonderful, sir, he says as he starts tapping his pen on the table.
So, let's... How about we join in a partnership that allows us to both benefit from this end goal?
Two heavy sets of footprints. Steps come up from behind you. The guards for the museum grab you harshly and show you to the door.
Should I give him an example of fast talking?
Yes.
Alright. Fast talking, you'd want to walk up to him and say, so I saw that you have a room in the back there and you got this machine going on right there and I see the plant that I recognize. I've been on a trip with the experiment that you're trying to get going and I know what it's going to go.
Literally talking quickly.
Yeah.
No, you talk over them, you keep going and you give them reasons and you talk them into your thing.
That's not fast talking.
Not necessarily. Fast talk could be done quickly or slowly, variably. It's a matter of trying to get somebody to see things your way.
Give them all the reasons and don't let them interrupt.
Well, the thing is, you also want to make sure you don't throw in crazy.
Yeah.
Going in there going, so I saw you had a whole bunch of equipment going on in the back there. I'm not sure what kind of experiment you're planning on doing, but that plant in the back looks awfully familiar. I think I've dealt with that before. What are you planning on doing with it? Oh, well, I'd love to be on the ground floor of that. Actually, I know a whole bunch of people would love to be on board with it. When you have a sign-up sheet, make sure you talk to me first. I'd love to. This kind of, you know.
Talking on your feet. Like thinking on your feet. But.
I heard to use that a little pamphlet on Skype for you to read real quick.
A little pamphlet.
Yeah, it's more than a line or two.
Wait, you're trying to get him to join a cult or something?
Yep.
Yes.
I don't think that works on him.
It does in this scenario. It's a very.
I know what he's up to. Anyway, it doesn't matter. In any case, at this point, you being shown out of the room, and the others, incidentally, I'm going to give you the quick update that upon checking the asylum, no, Apricot Guy is not at the asylum anymore.
Okay.
Matter of fact, when you actually start asking around for me, not actually knowing his name, they have no idea who you're referring to, but they certainly have not taken anyone in claiming to have been drinking strange beverages made of apricot.
Wait, wouldn't he be dead?
What?
Like, unless he was participating in the experiments with us. Yeah, he would have been.
He was. Yeah, he was.
But the experiments haven't started yet, so what did Thalu participate
in? The NPC that played the part in the old experiments that had the apricots before, that NPC is still alive and still has the memories.
Right, yeah, that's true.
And Thalus has her memories from the last session, up to the point that she died.
Just a minute, we're almost done.
Yeah, but certain things that have changed on the world as a result of the choices between yesterday's session and the dream of last night have not changed in her perspective because she didn't make it to the planet. Yes, it's complicated.
Yep. So Apricot Guy is not there. I will. Who followed me to the insanitarium?
I think it was just you.
Okay.
And in any case, at this point, I am called because we've ran long enough tonight, and I'm going to be cutting this stream. Well, it's not actually a live stream; it's a local. Yeah. But regardless, cutting the recording now.